Proximity switches are common in factories and process plants, where they're used to control the position and flow of goods through the manufacturing process. There are three basic types of proximity switches. With an optical switch, the object breaks an infrared beam. Mechanical switches require physical contact between the relay and the object, while magnetic switches use a magnetic field to make or break a relay contact. As process speeds increase, timing and signal transitions become more critical to reliable operation. Over time, internal switch contacts corrode. Arcing can cause pitting on the surface, and the impedance across the contacts can change. Usually, these problems arise slowly and gradually worsen before they fail permanently. While hard faults can be easy to diagnose visually or with simple measurements with a digital multimeter, it's the gradual or intermittent failures that cause the most headaches. An oscilloscope will save you hours of trial and error by giving you graphical access to analyze signal amplitude, transition, and time relationship details. In our example, a proximity switch is causing erratic operation in a parts sorting system. The meter amplitude readings, voltage peak max and peak min, show that the switch is changing state. The digital multimeter can also tell us the rate the switch is changing state. None of that, however, helps us diagnose the problem. So, do we take the chance and replace the controller? Using the Fluke ScopeMeter, let's look at the switch change state graphically. An oscilloscope will show amplitude, switch on-off state timing, and the time relationship between a reference signal. So what about timing? We've connected the oscilloscope to capture both the signal from the proximity switch and the controller output pulse. It's immediately clear that something is off. At a glance, you can see the channel A trace is not stable relative to the channel B output from the proximity switch. Zooming in to look at it in even greater detail, you can see the output from the proximity switch isn't changing state from off to on in one single transition. The contacts are bouncing on and off about 5 milliseconds before the output stays on. In this case, the controller is detecting the multiple changes of state from on to off and reading these as individual switch openings and closures. That's what's causing the erratic behavior. A DMM can show precise amplitude and time measurements, and will let you know when a switch fails to open or close. But when it comes to those subtle intermittent events, the Fluke ScopeMeter will give you the details you need to diagnose the problem. A picture is worth 1,000 words. The more you can see, the more you can fix.